while back, I did a video about Plague of Shadows, Shovel Knight's first DLC. Well, some time has gone by, and since then, we've gotten the second DLC from Yacht Club Games, and I have to say, it's another great piece of quality content. It's really a refreshing and compelling take on Shovel Knight. I've been struggling to write this video. What is it about this game that makes it tick? What is so compelling about it? The story is really good, sure, and they cut out a lot of the fat, like completely ditching the overworld map in favor of a more Mega Man-style level selection, and they really just honed in on what makes the gameplay good, and while these changes are really great, it isn't quite enough to define what is so great about this campaign. Well, if you recall in my Plague of Shadows video, I talked about how Plague Knight's adaptability and customization made for rich and engaging gameplay. Well, Spectre Knight is not the evil genius that Plague Knight is, so functionally, his gameplay does not line up with the same philosophy as Plague Knight's, or Shovel Knight's for that matter. In fact, if we had to break it down, I would line up the three current Shovel Knight campaigns to follow these three themes. Vanilla Shovel Knight is all about challenge and tricky platforming, so in a word, his gameplay philosophy would probably be precision. Plague Knights would be adaptability, and Spectre Knights would be motion. Yes, where Spectre Knights' gameplay really comes into its own is the fluidity of the movement. Everything in this campaign comes down to movement, and since Yacht Club knew this, they made sure that Spectre Knights' movement felt really good. It feels great to control Spectre here. Now, this is not to say that Shovel Knight and Plague Knight control poorly. In fact, I really love these guys for their own reasons. But in comparison to Spectre Knight, Shovel Knight feels somewhat stiff, and Plague Knight feels chaotic. Of course, these different gameplay styles suit the characters behind them. Plaguey here is bombastic, and Shovel Knight is strong-willed, and Spectre is, well, he's a smooth player. Seriously, this guy's platforming is super inventive, and I love it in all of its wall-jumping glory. But let's take a closer look into the mechanics. Spectre Knight can jump with moderate success. His normal jump is nothing to write home. his normal jump is really nothing to write home about. But the devs took care to make sure that this guy had more to him than just a simple jump. As soon as you start jumping, you're going to be doing the wall jump, and a lot of it. But to aid the precision and for player ease, the devs included a small climb into Spectre's wall jump, meaning that your button press doesn't have to be as immediate as, say, a wall jump in Metroid or Mario. This small touch gives him quick, precise verticality that's easy to control. Then there's the dash slash. This move allows Spectre to dash diagonally into the air, dependent on the object or enemy. A successful dash slash can gain a lot of verticality quickly. With both wall jumps and dash slashes used in conjunction with each other, it makes for incredibly fun platforming challenges. My only gripe with this third Shovel Knight campaign is that Spectre Knight is too strong. This campaign is really easy compared to the other two. Boss fights are incredibly easy with Spectre Knight, with Spectre Knight being able to basically just spam that dash slash until victory. Now, Plague Knight actually had this same problem in my opinion, but just not to the same degree. I mean, I beat the final boss on my first try, and because of the versatility of his control, platforming, while super fun, is nowhere near as challenging. If you slightly mistime your jump and fall short, you can easily wall jump or flip up over a ledge in order to save yourself. Shovel Knight simply didn't have this luxury, and Plague Knight, just landing Plague Knight's jumps was a challenge on its own. While I enjoy not dying as much, I didn't feel like this game challenged me as much as Shovel Knight's original campaign did. However, the great story, which I'm not going to be going into in this video because of spoilers and because it's just a great story, and because of just how fun the platforming and gameplay is, it totally offsets all of these complaints. I had an amazing time with Spectre of Torment, and while I don't think it's my favorite of the three campaigns, that may just be because Plague Knight is wonderful and I love him. I would still say that this game is totally worth your time and money. Yacht Club totally nailed it again with this one, and you should definitely play it. Anyways guys, that's all I've got this time. I promise I will be back with more stuff for you guys soon. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to like and subscribe. and I'll see you guys all next time. Okay guys, thanks so much for watching. Bye-bye.